Hi, and welcome to the Finbox Academy. In the prior lesson of this dividends course, we discussed one way to spot a risky dividend using the dividend payout ratio. It's never a good idea to rely on a single ratio for your analysis. In this lesson, we'll discuss some other tools you can use to determine if a company's distributions to shareholders are sustainable in the long term. You will learn how to use the dividend coverage ratio to pick winning dividend stocks and avoid the losers. The dividend coverage ratio is a financial indicator that tells you how many times a company's operating cash flow can cover the dividend. If a company generates $50 billion in cash flow from operations and pays $10 billion in dividends, it has a dividend coverage ratio of 5. Just like the dividend payout ratio, the dividend coverage ratio is a powerful instrument in the hands of income investors, as it can help avoid bad investment decisions. If you find a stock with a 15% dividend yield, you may be tempted to buy it in hopes of enjoying a substantial income stream. But what if the company has a 0.4 dividend coverage ratio? A dividend coverage ratio below 1 suggests that the company can't pay its dividend using cash flows earned from business activity, a situation that is not sustainable in the long run. As mentioned before, the dividend coverage ratio is equal to cash flow from operations divided by total dividends paid. Some investors prefer to calculate it as the reciprocal of the dividend payout ratio dividing net income by total dividends paid. You may be wondering which dividend coverage ratio formula you should use. At Finbox, we use the cash flow version, since cash from operations is harder to manipulate than reported net income. Furthermore, it is essential to check for cash flow profitability to get a more genuine sense of a company's ability to handle the dividend with ease. The pressure on management to consistently deliver strong earnings is real and well documented as earnings management. Net income may govern stock price reactions, but income investors need to be confident that a company has the cash flow to pay its dividend. To illustrate, we can use the formula above to calculate Microsoft's dividend coverage ratio. Using the Finbox Data Explorer, we can find the values of the metrics required to apply the formula. Microsoft total dividends and Microsoft cash flow from operations. We can now calculate Microsoft dividend coverage ratio by dividing the cash flow from operations by total dividends. Microsoft's coverage ratio suggests that the company can pay its dividend 3.9 times with its cash flow from operations. That puts Microsoft around the 50th percentile for dividend-paying stocks in the US information technology sector. You don't need to do the calculation alone, and you don't have to use a dividend coverage ratio calculator. You can use the Finbox Data Explorer to access dividend coverage ratio data for 100,000 plus companies worldwide. The average dividend coverage ratio varies greatly among different sectors, so it is very useful to compare a company to its sector while evaluating it. As of July 4, 2020, the sectors with the highest dividend coverage ratios are industrials, healthcare, and energy. Real estate, consumer staples, and utilities are the sectors with the lowest dividend coverage ratio. You can have up-to-date stats and graphs like that directly in Excel or in Google Spreadsheets with the Finbox Excel add-in. To download it for free, go to finbox.com/integrations/Excel. After you download the Excel add-in, you can download the sector benchmark model using the link in the description below. If you're trying to determine what constitutes a good dividend coverage ratio, there are no hard and fast rules. As you can see from the previous chart, dividend coverage ratios vary considerably from one sector to another, ranging from 5.65 for industrials to less than 2 for real estate, since REITs required by law to distribute 90% of taxable income to retain their tax-efficient structure. A healthy dividend coverage ratio is above 1 and the sector average. When a company pays a high dividend compared to other companies in the sector, there is a high chance that the distribution is not sustainable in the long term, as the dividend may need to be cut at the first sign of a recession or financial hardship. A too low coverage ratio could also indicate that the company is not retaining enough cash to reinvest and compete effectively in the market over the long run. Investing in businesses with a too low dividend coverage ratio could cost you a lot of money. You can check if the dividend coverage ratio of your companies is sustainable in the long term by comparing it to the sector average using the Finbox Data Explorer. Before you leave, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because in the following days, we'll publish new videos that will help you learn everything about dividends for free. See you at the next lesson.